The class selector is recognized by the period sign, followed by a class name. The class can be either a general class that can be applied to any element, or a specific class that can only be applied to one type of element. Either way, to use a class rule, we need to specify where in the document it should be applied. This is done using the class attribute with its value set to the class name. Next, we have the ID selector, which works much like the class selector. It uses a pound sign instead of a period. Also, each ID selector should only be used once per document, since the ID attribute needs to be unique. Therefore, we will only use ID selectors when we want to make sure that a style is only used once. The class selector, on the other hand, can be assigned to any number of elements, and both the ID and class attributes can be applied to all HTML elements. Say, for example, that we want some paragraphs to have color, but not all of them. Then we first need to add a class rule with a color property. This rule says that any element whose class attribute has the value of info will have this style. So, to apply it, we just need to add that class name to the element. Next, if we want a class to only work for paragraph elements, we can instead create a specific class or subclass and add it to the document. We can apply the ID selector in the same way as the class. This rule will match the one and only element whose ID attribute is set to that ID. We can only use one ID to each element, but we can apply more than one class by separating them with a space. The span and div elements work especially well with the class and ID selectors. These elements are generic ways of adding structure to a document, and they have no styles associated with them. The difference between the two is that span is an inline element and div is a block element.